Dear all, we were seeing public address system in the last module. There we have seen the basic block diagram and how it is working, what are the major operations, all those things. Not in detail, but in the surface level we have seen. Then the next session in this module, that is in public address system, that is amplifier. Amplifier is the heart of public address system. The one of the major requirement or application that met by electronics or electronics engineering, that is amplification. Till 1947, we were using vacuum tubes for amplifications. After inventing transistor, that is BJT, then MOSFET, FET, all those things, we are using these semiconductor devices for amplification, and they are the best device till now we are using for amplification. We are not able to replace this device till now. And for bipolar junction transistor, it has majorly two application. One is it can act as a switch, that is on switch or off switch. Then second one, it can act as an amplifier. So we are going to see detail about amplifier in this session. So first of all, what is amplifier? The device which is doing amplification, this is generally known as amplifier. Device, not device, the circuit which is amplifying the signal, it is generally known as amplifier. Then the next question, what is amplification? This is nothing but this is the process of increasing the strength of input signal, amplitude of the signal, by means of energy drawn from an external source. This is very, very important. No circuit or no device will not amplify a signal without using external source. It cannot generate energy by itself, because if we are saying a device it is amplifying or it is amplifying power or something like that by its own, it is actually against the law of energy conservation. That is, energy cannot be created nor be destroyed, but it can transfer from one form to another. Okay. So actually energy per time, that is actually power, that is in per second what is the energy we are taking. So this power we cannot create. So normally in amplification what happens is there will be an external source, power source. And we have one signal, input signal. This power source is continuously giving the power to this device, and device taking this power from the source and giving to this input signal, so that the amplitude of the input signal is increasing, means its power is increasing. So if here it is 1 volt, sometimes here it is 5 volt. So the amplification or gain of this device, it is 5. If I am giving 1 volt, it will give 5 volt. If I am giving 2 volt, it will give 10 volt. If I am giving 10 volt, it will give 50 volt. That is the ideal concept. So a circuit which taking the energy from external supply and by using that energy or power, increasing the amplitude of input signal, such a circuit generally known as amplifier. Okay, then very important concept, the shape of the signal should be same, that is at input side and output side, this shape should be same. If here it is sine wave and here it is giving a square wave, then it is not an amplifier. It is supposed to keep the same shape. Along that, one more concept is there. Here only one cycle between these two time period. That is, if I am saying here it is T1 and here it is T2, between T1 and T2 only one cycle is there. And again the same time period T1 and T2 we are taking here, and it is giving two cycle like this with this amplitude. Then again also that is not good one. Amplifier will not change the frequency of the input signal. Very, very important. Amplifier will not change the frequency of input signal. It will not change the shape of the input signal, but it increases the amplitude. Sometimes it will change the phase, because here it is high and here it is low. Instead of the that one, then again we are getting here it is again high and low. Instead of that one, I am getting low here and high here, like this. But again between T1 and T2 only one cycle is there. Number of cycles is not changed, mean frequency is not changed. So that is the second important thing. So this is generally we can say what is an amplifier. Then we can see what are the important characteristics of an amplifier. One, it is gain of the signal. So gain means it is how much increase in the amplitude. It can be voltage gain or current gain. So you have to note one thing here. Here we just mentioned increasing the strength of the input signal or amplitude of the input signal. Amplitude means it can be a voltage signal or it can be a current signal. Due to that reason we said amplitude. We didn't say it increasing the amplitude of it increasing the voltage or it increasing the current. Generally for the amplitude, that is the peak value of this voltage and current together, we will say amplitude. That amplitude can be either voltage or it can be current. So gain will be what is the output voltage of the amplified signal divided by what is the input voltage of the given signal. That is, for this amplifier device, if the previous example, just I mentioned, I am giving 1 volt signal here, 1 and minus 1 volt, and I am getting 5 and minus 5. So gain for 1 volt it is giving 5, minus 1 it is giving minus 5. So gain is 5 divided by 1 or minus 5 divided by minus 1, it is 5. Then it will be, normally we are saying amplifier is a linear circuit, means if it is giving, if we are saying gain is A, that A V out by V in, it is 5 in this example, then for 1 volt it should give 5 volt. Then if I am giving 2 volt, gain is 5, then 2 into 5 it should give 10 volt. If this amplitude here it is 7 volt, gain is 5, 7 into 5, 35 volt should be the peak. It should be continue up to infinity, that is the ideal concept. But it is, we know it is not practically possible. So there is a limitation for the linear range of operation. Then second one, so based on this gain, we can say voltage gain is there, current gain is there, power gain is there. That is output voltage by input voltage, output current by input current, output power by input power. Then never think that we are generating or creating any power here, because sometimes some of you may ask doubt, if we are increasing the power like this, then why we require dams and hydroelectric power station? We can just give the input signal here and we are getting high power signal here. But clearly understand the concept. Here we are taking an electrical energy with high power, and that energy we are giving to this signal, and for that one we are using this amplifier circuit. And even though in the hydroelectric power station, there also we are not generating any energy. No, sorry, we are not creating any energy. We are translating or we are changing mechanical energy to electrical energy only. We cannot create that one. Okay. Then remaining input resistance. What is the resistance we are seeing at the input side of the amplifier? That is input resistance. It should be large. Actually, or generally, we are saying about voltage amplifier. For those cases, input impedance should be large. Amplifiers are, you will study in detail about this one. Amplifiers are classified by four. That is voltage amplifier, current amplifier, transresistance amplifier, and transconductance amplifier. And for each of these cases, these conditions will change. Here we written the condition, we have written the condition of voltage amplifier, that is input impedance is high and output impedance, that is the impedance what we are seeing at the output side of amplifier, that should be low, small. That just opposite for current amplifier, input impedance should be small and output impedance should be high. So like that for transresistance and transconductance, it will change. Then bandwidth should be large. What is mean by bandwidth? That is the range of frequency of signal that you can amplify. It should be large. Range of frequency of signal. That is normally our voice signal, it will be 300 Hz to 3.5 kHz. Audio signal, the signal which we can hear, it is 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So if we are designing an amplifier, with a 10 kHz bandwidth, audio range, it has bandwidth 20 kHz. So I am saying it is 0 to 10 kHz. Then audio signal is 0 to 20 kHz. So 10 to 20 kHz, that signal will not amplify. To avoid that problem, we require high bandwidth for the amplifier. So these are the basic introduction, what is an amplifier and what are the basic parameters of an amplifier. We have seen that one. Next class we will see how transistor behave as an amplifier or transistor as an amplifier. So in the first session we will not see how transistor behave as an amplifier. We will see what is transistor, the basic properties of transistor and the concept of load line. Then after that, how it is working, its biasing, then we will see the amplification property of transistor. Thank you.